Subtracting fractions. We're going to start with a problem 3 and 2/5 minus 1 and 4/5. First, let us lay out the problem using fraction tiles. Traditionally, in business, red is used to represent a loss, so we'll be using red to show what we are taking away. We could use any color to represent what we started off with, but I chose to use yellow, since that color is frequently used to represent the unit pieces with other manipulatives. Looking back at the problem, you will notice that both fractions have a common denominator of 5. That means the whole was cut into 5 equal-sized pieces. If we just look at the fraction part, we have 2/5 of a piece, but we need to take away 4/5. We need more fifths. To do that, we will need to break up one of the wholes into 5 equal-sized pieces. This process is frequently referred to as regrouping. We still have our original 3 2/5, since 5/5 is equal to a whole. But we have chosen to write it as 2 5/5 2/5, or 2 7/5. Now we can take away 1 4/5. To do that, we will pair up each yellow tile with a red tile and remove them, leaving us 1 3/5. So 3 2/5 minus 1 4/5 is 1 3/5. It is important to visualize what is happening in the problem, then to translate what we are doing with the tiles to steps done on paper. We will not be able to use fraction tiles all the time, but we should use them until each step that we're doing on paper makes sense and we're not just memorizing rules. Now let's look at the situation where we don't have common denominators. 2 2/3 minus 1 1/5. When we look at the fraction tiles, we notice that the tile cut up into thirds is made of larger pieces than the tile cut into fifths. Before we can subtract, we need to be working with equal-sized pieces, so we need to find a common multiple. It's 15. So our common denominator will be 15. We can change the thirds into 15ths by adding 5 more lines going in the opposite direction of the tile. On paper, we would multiply 2/3 by 1, since you can multiply any number by 1 and not change its value. The trick is that we're going to write 1 as 5/5. So 2 times 5 is 10, 3 times 5 is 15, so 2/3 is the same thing as 10/15. And we can confirm that by looking back at our tiles. We will need to repeat this procedure for changing 1/5 into 3/15. Now I can subtract 1 3/15 from 2 10/15, getting 1 7/15. Let's look at one last problem. 4 1/6 minus 3 3/4. The first thing that we notice is the fractions do not have a common denominator. Some of my students would tell me that we should use 24 as a common denominator, but that's not the least common denominator. We will use the same procedure we did before. We can rewrite the problem as 4 2/12 minus 3 9/12. Since we only have 2/12, we cannot take away 9/12. We will have to change one of the unit pieces into 12/12. That would give us 3 12/12 2/12, or 3 14/12. Now we can subtract 3 9/12 from 3 14/12, leaving us with 5/12. So did it really matter if we used 12 or 24 as our common denominator? I will quickly redo the problem on paper, using 24 as the common denominator. In the end, we got the same answer, but when we don't use the least common denominator, we will always have to reduce the final answer. If you need more help with fractions, please go to frontporchmath.com. There you will find more videos, written explanations, and review sheets.